Hi everyone, today I'm gonna show you guys how to create an Instagram feed like my, not like mine, but that has all the posts, all the feeds connect together, like what I have on my Instagram account. I know that I, like a lot of people are asking how I do this, because not only my feed connects to the left and to the right, but also once I have a new post, you know, it pushes down, it connects to top and bottom. So it never breaks. I mean, it breaks on left and right, but then you can see this notebook is connected to that notebook. Okay, so here we go. This, I use Photoshop, and then the function that I use to make these connected posts are Artboards. It's not that new function, but I don't remember which version they start to have Artboard. So you probably, if you have a really, really old version of Photoshop, you might not have it, but I think most people have that function. And let me first explain the logic of it. So because I want my feed, my post to connect on all sides, so even though in my head I'm thinking, oh, this feed is on the top left corner, I am gonna try to change the way you think on how you post a feed. So you want to think that your feed is the one, this one, the post that you're gonna post is the one in the middle, and then you want to make sure it connects to all sides, all of its neighbors. So that's why I drew this 3x3 diagram to show you. So the one in the middle is this feed, that this post that we're gonna create, and the one to the right is a previous, and then, you know, the previous. And then we want to keep in mind on the future post, so when we do our layout, we can have like these, maybe like objects overlapping. Then like I have here like a camera that I use too much, it's, you know, some, like, it's overlapping, you know, between the grid lines. Okay, so how do you create this Instagram grid? We can start by going to Photoshop and create, what am I doing? Get a new document. And I'm using 1080 by 1080. I'm not really worried about, oh, what's going on? I'm not really worried about, like, what you call that right now. I think it looks fine when I just do 1080 by 1080, and then it's 72 dpi RGB color, and you can do white background or transparent background depending on how you want your Instagram feed to look. My feed looks, you know, like everything is on a white background. That's just the way I choose. You can definitely have, you know, your whole feed is on a black or gray or pink background, or a pattern, you know, go crazy. So I'm just gonna do white here, and the most important thing is you wanna click Artboard. So you're creating one Artboard that's 1080 by 1080. And once you hit create, you're gonna have this one Artboard. And if you use the move tool, if you click on the name of the Artboard, you are operating on like this Artboard world, and you can create duplicate the Artboard however many you need. So we're gonna create 9. Okay, I'm gonna zoom now so you can see what's going on here. So I have created 3. I'm just gonna do one underneath and then left, down. Oh, I don't like how it's moving. It's making me dizzy. Okay, so there we go. We have 9 Artboard. And you can see all the names is just 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 tonight. That's very, very, so clear and so confusing at the same time. And the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna reposition it so they're all close together, like how our Instagram feed looks like. So like you don't want any like gap in between like what we have here. So we're gonna position the Artboard. Well, the first one we don't have to do anything, but the second one just on. If your Photoshop is like mine right now, what's doing is showing me inches. You can just, you know, right click on your ruler. Well, if you don't have ruler, you're gonna do Command and R, and then you get a ruler out, and then you wanna do pixel, so you're viewing this. So Artboard 1 is 1080 by 1080, and Artboard 2, we want it to be, the X position is 1080, so we're just, you know, moving it over, and Artboard 3 is 2160, right? Simple math. And then Artboard 6, we want to do 1080 one as a Y. And Artboard 5 is 1080 and 1080. And Artboard, this one is 2160 and 1080. And this one is gonna be 2160, 1080, 2160. So if this is very confusing, just refer back to the diagram that I have on the blog post. So these are the coordinates you wanna key in. So it's, you know, it's just multiply 1080. Okay, so now we have the artboard. We're gonna change these names, so you know, it will follow this diagram that I provide. So I'm just gonna name them 0, plus 1, plus 2, plus 3, plus 4, and the minus 1, 2, 3, 4. So the minus ones are, you know, what happened yesterday, my post yesterday and the previous day. So those are gonna, they're just there so I can see the layout, but you'll see why do we need them. So what's this? This is 9, so this is, I'm gonna do minus 4. 3. Okay, so once again I changed the name and then changed the position. So if you don't like, if I wasn't clear on what I was doing, so you need to have this property panel open. Property looks like these, you know, funky thing. If you don't have it, it's somewhere here, property. Okay, and now all the artboards are glued together, it's hard to tell who's who, so we're gonna create some guides. Let's do, hey, show me the guy. We're gonna have guys on 1080. That was weird. Okay. 2060 and then vertical 2060. So these are just, you know, oh, that was funny. Why is it doing that? Oh, because I have the artboard selected. Oh no. Okay, that was a good mistake that I do to show you guys. So click off any layer so you are not, you know, creating guides to a specific layer. So you don't have any layers highlighted, and then you create a guide. I use guide so much that I even have a shortcut key for it. So it's 1080. So these are the two numbers you wanna remember. 1080 and 2160. Okay, now we have these guys, we can tell the 9 grids. Okay, so if what I just did is like, you were like, what in the world is going on? That's all right. I have a link for you guys to have this Photoshop template. So you don't even have to click your, you know, create your own. You can just download it and then just bam, it's right there for you. Okay, so now let me jump back to the grid that I've been using all this time. Not all this time, like lately. So I have all these grids just like the one I would just create, except that I already have content, so these are my previous posts. And for you guys, if you're just starting, you would still, you know, start placing your artwork in the middle, but you would just not have, you know, these previous posts. So first thing is to move everything one block over, right? One grid over. So we're gonna just scoop to the right and then dump the last, you know, minus 4. So delete that layer. You wanna keep, you know, the what you call that, a layer, like a white layer, or for me, because I'm doing things on white background. And then you just move, you know, number 3 to minus 3 to minus 4, so things just scoop over. And for these old posts, I usually, as soon as, you know, they move down to, as they became old, I would just, you know, merge them. I would merge the layers so they don't take out, they don't take up as much memory, I guess, you know, space in my hard disk, because my poor computer has so much junk in it. Okay, so now everybody scooped one, you know, block over, one grid over. We have a space for our new post. I'm just gonna close the other one so it's not as confusing. Okay, so remember, we're gonna place our new artwork or design, you know, whatnot that you wanna, you know, post, but you cannot have them bleed to the, you know, old post. So that means you cannot go to the right, you cannot go to the bottom, you cannot even touch this one, which you won't. It's impossible. And I have this artwork that, you know, this piece I wanna post. So I just select on the group and then do duplicate group. And then I will select the document, which is I call my document 3x3 grid. And since it's a document that has multiple artboard, it will let me select which artboard. So I'm gonna do 0, which is the center one that we wanna paste in. Okay, so let's jump back to this new grid file. So I have this artwork in the middle, and it's here. So the first thing I wanna do is to make it a smart object, just so you know. I don't know, it's just a habit. I don't know why I do that. I think it's a good habit, so you guys should do it too. Oh, you know, this one actually, I'm just gonna have it like maybe go to the next grid right here. I'm just gonna have it like, you know, extend to the tomorrow's post or whenever I do the next post. But, you know, just for the sake of demonstration, I'm actually gonna move it to so it touches all three neighbors, which is kind of, you know, I don't think that's a good layout because it's too much empty space here. But just for the sake of showing you guys how to do this. So let's say, you know, I wanted to have it like here, you know, you can however far you want to do. And this one just so happened is too, you know, it's actually an easier post. Like the other one, I have like coffee cup and, you know, clipboard and that. But this one's just one frame. But it will still do the job. So I have this one already. Let's see. I'm gonna, because I don't like my paperclip kind of like feeling, it feels like the shadow is, actually it's not that bad. Right. Okay, I thought it was blocking my paperclip, but it's not. It's fine. I mean, sometimes you have to play with the layers. If you think it's, you know, if it's, oh, that's not good. See, I didn't mask out the layers. That's why I should keep it in the bottom. So, you know, if things like it's gonna touch each other, then you wanna carefully mask out this paperclip so you're not, you know, touching anything. So when you're planning it, you can kind of plan ahead to avoid having to mask out crazy curve, you know, shape. That's what I would do. I would avoid crazy shape stuff. Okay. Now we're gonna copy and duplicate the same thing to the neighbor. So we're just gonna do right click and then duplicate layers and then duplicate to artboard plus one. Ta-da, there we go. And then it's like, oh, in the wrong position, what is going on? That's all right, we're just gonna move, you know, we're gonna move everything 1080 pixel to the right so it will match, so it would, you know, what's another word, match. I really don't have many vocabulary. By doing this free transform command T, you will have this, you know, the coordinate, the center of the position of that layer or that group layer, and you just want to add 1080 to this number. So here is 414 plus 1080. I have a calculator on my desk. If you can do it in your head, you can do that too. So it's 1494. There. So it's like matching. But it's actually two different layer. And you wanna do the same thing, like copy the same one to the, you know, neighbor, to the upstairs neighbor. So we wanna copy this part to our board plus four. So let's do right click, duplicate layer, and do plus four. And it's all the way there. We're gonna move it down. This time we're gonna move down on the y, along the y axis. So 489 plus 1080 is 1569. Now there, oh, that angle is it's quite, I hope you guys can see it. So there we have that little angle, not angle, corner. Oh, Vivian, it's too late for me to do this. Now we're gonna do the same thing for this one. I'm gonna copy it to upstairs too. So upstairs it's +3. And then the same thing, move it. It's the same one, right? Yeah. Okay, so now we have a frame. So it looks like one picture, but it's actually four different, you know, pieces. And then this is, and then you can come and select these four. One, two, this one, and then this one. You wanna come and select these duplicate ones that you just created, and you wanna link them. And the reason for doing this is that, in case if you, now you decide, oh, you know, like now I'm gonna decide, okay, it's way too high, I'm gonna move it, you know, down a little bit. So I just need to have one selected, and once I move, you know, all the other three is gonna follow, because they're all linked, right? There we go. Okay, so, you know, obviously I'm doing this just to show you guys, because I'm gonna move it down because this is just like a huge empty space. But you see, you can actually, you know, you can do as many overlap as you want. And I don't think you need to overlap on all three sides, you know, all the time. Like a lot of time I just have like overlap on one side, or, you know, one little thing. So there's no need to, you know, cover all of them, just one or two, you know, sometimes none of them is overlapping, that's fine too. Wanna make them look random. So that's almost done, right? So this is the layout that I wanna post. And how are you gonna export this? Just by, there we go, you select on this layer 0, and then you just right click and say you wanna export as, that's you can export like multiple version, different sizes, but I don't need to do any of that. This is just for Instagram post. So I don't need to change anything. I just, you know, export all. And then I have like, and then I'll just do like a number, you know. I mean, I have all my thing in the same place. Actually, no, I'm gonna do A3 in the next one. There. So now you have the post, and then you can, you know, send that to your phone, you know, drop it, you know, airdrop it, or post it on, post, you know, directly from your desktop, however you do your Instagram post. So that's it. That's all you need to, I mean, that's all there is that I can show you. I hope I'm not leaving, you know, like making you guys more confused, you know, because it's really that simple, you know. My guess is like now you're like, what? That's all you have to do? I can't believe I waited for this tutorial. Could I figure out myself? Yeah, that's right. It's very simple. So go crazy with you guys, you know, with it. Like do, you know, I want you to have fun. Like I want to see what you can do with it. Like, you know, do a crazy background, or like my initial idea is to have like this as like almost like an endless table. So you keep putting things on the table, you know, but you can do like a wall, like you're climbing up, you know, as you are like looking, you know, sweeping up, upward, you know, on a wall. That's so everything, all of your artwork is hanged on the wall, and different frames and then different things you hang on the wall, you know, different shelves, you know, that'll be cool. Or, you know, do different pattern, or you don't even have to do, you know, you can even just do a huge collage, you know, just be collage that connects to each other. That'll be cool too. Okay, so let me know what you guys think, and if I need to explain anything, or if, you know, if I just made you more confused, I'm so sorry. I'm not very good at teaching. So let me know, you know, leave a comment in my post or on Instagram, DM me, however whatever you want to tell me. So I hope you guys, you know, get something out of this. So let me know if you have any more questions. Thank you for watching this. Bye.